Well, well, it looks like we have a mess to clean. You want a breakfast sandwich, Beastie? How quaint. My, my, what an awkward situation. It looks as if you didn't clean the way I asked you to, Beastie, and now I shall have to put you into a death-like sleep so you don't take everything out right as I put it away. Like last time. Hush, little Beastie, don't say a word. Well, well, Lucas decided to get up. See, Beastie, there's nothing under your bed but toys. And even if there was something vicious, I am the mistress of all evil, so I could command it to leave, and it would have to obey. Now do go to sleep. Your godmother is exhausted. This infernal beast. I wish I had my wings back. They would be so much easier than this. What are all these buttons for? I don't even know where to start. Can somebody please open the sunroof? My horns don't even fit. That white truck just cut me off. I shall have to curse him into a death-like sleep. A sleep from which he will... Godmother, you can't just go around cursing everybody who cuts you off in traffic. All right, Beastie, but there was nothing in the instruction manual about cursing other drivers. Sorry I'm late. Traffic, you know. What did I miss?
Yes, you are late. We were just about to talk about the bake sale.
Don't worry. I have the bake sale covered.
Excuse me, but are those Oreos?
Oh, yes, but I conjured them myself.
Okay, next order of business is the new school playground. We're going to need...
I have my strongest fairies on that. We'll gather a team together and they can assemble the whole thing in one day.
Last on our agenda is... the school fair.
My fairies are on that too. I have a group that will be doing rides for the children, and another group that will be doing flower hair braiding.
You and your team of fairies are so great. Why don't you run for PTA president?
I, Maleficent, shall be running as your new PTA president. Here is my platform. Your playground space is concrete. There is no place for children to play. I will plant trees to make it look very much like the moors where I grew up. Secondly, I also have a team of fairies who are willing to come in to give teachers an extra break so that they may have more planning time. And finally, all naughty children will be put into a death-like sleep.
What do you mean I can't say that?
Beastie, are you quite sure this is where you would like to frolic for the day? It seems a bit full of humans.
Yeah!
Very well, let's get settled then. Come here and let me put sunblock on you before you burn up. Then I will just stay here in the shade of this tree so I don't ruin my fair complexion.
What are you staring at?
Be gone.
Beastie, I'm afraid we must go to the store. It seems our washing machine has run out of laundry detergent.
Tajay! I suppose this will do. Laundry detergent. Oh, we could do with some new picture frames. Look at this darling lantern. I must have it. Beastie, this tiny clock has a bird on it, just like the moors. Throw pillows, yes please. Beastie, isn't he darling here? You must have it.
Beastie, I do believe that store put an enchantment on us. I don't even remember purchasing laundry detergent, which is what I came for, but look at all these other things I found.
Oh, what a beautiful day, Beastie. I am so pleased that you've decided to take up soccer.
Well, well, it looks as if everyone has brought snacks for the team except for us. There, protein bars for everyone. Now, where shall I sit? I suppose this will do. What are you all staring at?
Well done, Beastie! Touchdown!
What do you mean touchdown is from football and not soccer? Aren't they the same thing?
Foul ball!
For heaven's sakes, cut me some slack. This is my first time at a game.
Beastie, darling, I'm so proud of you. You will be winning the Super Bowl in no time.
Beastie, darling. I do not think I can prepare this chicken for dinner. If I touch it, I do believe that I shall get ill. Perhaps we could just go out to eat. In the malls, we ate things like nuts and berries, not whatever this is.
Well, well, what a lovely place.
May I take your order?
Yes, I would like a bowl of the quinoa salad.
Okay, but actually it's pronounced quinoa.
Right, the quinoa. And also a glass of freshly squeezed acai juice.
Acai.
I'm sorry, you see what?
How quaint.
Hello, and pleased to meet you. I'm here regarding the conference for Aurora, though I do think there must be some mistakes, seeing as she's doing splendidly in school.
So, you must be Aurora's mother.
Why, yes, I am her fairy godmother. So, what is this meeting about?
Well, I like to meet with all of my parents just to kind of see if they have any questions.
Yes, I do have a few questions regarding your curriculum.
Our curriculum is based completely on the state standards.
Those state standards you speak of don't spend nearly enough time on forest conservation.
There's just no time in the schedule to really do anything extra above or beyond.
Perhaps a guest speaker is in order. I'm sure you have time for that in your schedule. I can come in and share my expertise on the subject matter.
Excellent. I shall see you in 2 weeks' time.
Hello, beasties, and welcome to Forest Conservation 101. Rule number one, under any circumstances, good or bad, you must never ever cut down a single tree. This tree is thriving. Rule number two. Are you taking notes there? Come. I would also like you to plant some trees. 100 each per year, no less.
100 trees? That's kind of a lot.
Do you like breathing, Sue Ann? Well, then plant some trees. Rule number three. You must do away with all iron.
Iron? What does that have to do with nature?
I'm so glad you asked, Bobby. As mankind is poisoned by iron, it is poisonous therefore to nature.
These children ask such foolish questions.
Perhaps I should just curse them.
Godmother, no!
Fine. Rule number four, take time to enjoy nature. For the things you enjoy, you are most likely to protest. Thank you so much for attending my TED Talk.